Michael is taken to the warden's office and declares that he has nothing to do with the escape plan. Zavala expresses his desire to know who was behind it, and although Michael knows, he cannot say it because his life would be in danger. Seeing that Michael is not willing to confess, Zavala takes him out of the office. Michael is placed inside a plastic cage and exposed to the scorching sun in Panama. It doesn't take long for him to start sweating profusely, feeling dizzy and disoriented. Meanwhile, Mahone is brought back. The female assistant feels sorry for Mahone and gives him her father's talisman, asking him to return it once he's out. Reflecting on his previous misjudgment, Mahone feels uneasy. When Mahone passed by, he was confused. He thought Michael had escaped long ago. Michael, seeing Mahone's return, can only shake his head in disbelief, realizing they have come full circle. Whistler sees Mahone's return and approaches him, stating that the escape plan is not over and they should continue their efforts. Whistler exchanges a glance with Lechero. Bellick assumes that Teabag is involved in the escape plan, but Teabag himself wishes he had a role in it. Unfortunately, he is currently clueless and doesn't know what's going on. Sammy's subordinate sees Bellick and asks him to clean up the vomit on the floor, but Bellick pushes him into the mess with a single push. Meanwhile, Whistler is following Michael's plan and digging a hole with Lechero. However, they realize that they need an engineer if they don't want to be buried alive. With Lechero's cover, Whistler has no choice but to leave first, and Teabag witnesses the scene. Lincoln successfully escapes the company's plot to kill him and saves Sophia's life in the process, earning her trust. Lincoln makes Sophia realize that Whistler is a fraud. Sophia wants to rescue the person, and Lincoln agrees to help because of his son. Susan arrives, and Lincoln is forced into the car, while Sophia is warned once again to stay at home. The company's rescue mission failed, so Lincoln still has value. To keep Lincoln in check, Susan shows him a glimpse of his son. Lincoln's immediate reaction is to take LJ away, but LJ tells his father not to act impulsively. Susan cuts off Sarah's head, and although I couldn't see it, I could hear it even with my eyes covered. Lincoln assures his son that he will rescue him. At this point, Michael is starting to lose his consciousness, and Sucre encounters Augusto. Augusto asks Sucre to deliver a package and Sucre is unable to refuse when he sees the gun the man is holding. When Sucre approaches, he coincidentally sees Zavala and asks the guard to bring water for Michael. Seeing that the guard is reluctant, Sucre offers to do it himself. He looks at Michael, determined to rescue him, but Michael advises Sucre not to act rashly. Zavala approaches Michael and tries to persuade him, saying that he won't last more than 3 days if he continues like this. Michael responds, "I don't think you can beat those guys." Zavala becomes defiant. In the past, there was also a very powerful person. Now, Lechero is inside, but I am in control here. Michael declares that he has been planning the escape since the moment he entered. Zavala challenges him to prove it by escaping. Whistler, who is keeping an eye on Michael, panics, realizing that he might be exposed. Just when he is worried, Teabag suddenly shows up. Teabag suggests that Sammy might discover their actions and proposes a plan to eliminate him. Teabag's plan is to have Mahone confront Sammy in a duel. He has been providing Mahone with illegal substances for free, and now it's time for Mahone to repay the favor. Michael revealed how the company framed them, kidnapped his nephew, and coerced him into helping with an escape plan. Zavala was skeptical at first but later discovered that some of what Michael said was true. However, he still needed Michael's testimony. Michael emphasized the dangerous nature of the people involved and insisted on rescuing his nephew. Meanwhile, Sophia confronted Whistler, demanding to know who the woman was and why her passport had a different name. Whistler couldn't hide the truth any longer and explained that the passport was for their escape after they were released from prison. Sophia was torn between believing and not believing, and she watched as Whistler was taken away by the guards, looking confused. Zavala called Whistler in for questioning, but he denied anyone wanting to save him. Whistler claimed that Michael's words couldn't be trusted because he suffered from delusions. Zavala just wanted a name and pressured Whistler, who initially claimed not to know anything. Zavala brought out the torture rack, and Whistler didn't hold out for long. He confessed that the escape was planned by him and Michael, with no third person involved. Zavala then confronted Michael about the situation. Michael urged Whistler to tell the truth and asked about the woman he had been meeting with. Whistler struggled, accusing Michael of being crazy and warning that revealing their names would result in the death of Sarah and Michael's nephew. Michael believed Zavala could help them, but without a name, he couldn't do anything. After some thought, Whistler revealed that the woman's name was Gretchen Morgan. Michael was shocked to discover that Susan's real name was Gretchen Morgan and questioned how much truth this woman had told. However, having a name alone wasn't enough to catch her. Michael assured them that he had a plan and called Lincoln to find out where he would meet Susan next. Lincoln arranged to meet Susan at a bar in an hour, providing both a time and location. Sucre informed Lincoln about Michael being held in solitary confinement. leaving Lincoln unsure of his next move. Later, Sucre and Lincoln had a heated argument in the hallway, with Sucre asking for money to leave. Lincoln expressed his disdain, questioning why he should pay for helping a friend. The two parted ways on bad terms. The surveillance team reported the situation to Susan, and she quickly found Sucre. Susan offered Sucre $50,000 to spy on Lincoln, but Sucre was torn and ultimately couldn't resist the temptation of money. He couldn't betray his brother. It was a plan devised by Lincoln. They pretended to have a falling out so that Susan would believe Sucre could be bribed, allowing them to feed her false information. Lincoln met with Susan, but Zavala appeared just as they started talking. Lincoln was bewildered when he saw Susan being taken away and quickly distanced himself, fearing the consequences of being involved. He claimed it had nothing to do with him. Susan denied knowing Whistler and Michael, while Zavala ordered the water hose turned on, listening as Susan endured torture. Whistler grew anxious. Michael questioned why Whistler seemed concerned about Susan. Whistler defended himself, claiming it was because he feared she wouldn't confess. Susan withstood the torture and continued to claim she knew nothing. Zavala knew Susan had connections and brought in the other two to confront her. Facing Zavala's gun, Whistler admitted that Susan was the person he had been in contact with. Susan no longer denied it and offered to lead them to find LJ. Zavala ordered the car to be prepared for departure. Michael looked at Susan and accused her of killing Sarah. Susan denied it, but Michael vowed not to let her go. Sammy took away what Sucre had helped Augusto bring in. Bellick discovered a chicken claw placed on his pillow and hurriedly went to find Lechero, questioning why there was a chicken claw. Sammy didn't give him a chance to appeal and informed him that the duel would take place after lunch. Bellick left in a hurry, causing Lechero to object, questioning Bellick's authority to arrange a duel. Sammy resisted and stated that he would have power in the future. Teabag warned Lechero that if Sammy defeated him, he wouldn't fare well either. Teabag went to find Mahone, who was experiencing a breakdown. However, Mahone refused the syringe Teabag offered. Desperate, Teabag realized it was a dead end and questioned why Mahone was holding back. In response, Mahone still refused to take the syringe, infuriating Teabag, who then proceeded to beat him. As Mahone convulsed on the ground, he took the amulet given to him by his female assistant. Her kindness made him realize that he shouldn't let himself fall into depravity. The duel was about to begin, and Bellick was in a panic. He wrapped a cloth around his hand and stuffed two cotton balls in his nose, mustering up the courage to charge into the arena. He was brutally beaten but managed to cover the mouth and nose of his opponent with his hand. The opponent became dizzy and was quickly defeated by Bellick. Bellick couldn't believe it, but the cheers around him confirmed the truth, and he began to celebrate. Teabag, who had been observing him closely, sensed something was amiss and picked up the cloth as he approached Bellick. He removed the cotton balls from his nose, and Bellick knew that his cheating had been discovered. It turned out that Bellick had soaked the cloth in acetone, but Teabag chose not to expose him. At that moment, Augusto was talking to Sammy, asking if he had seen what he had given him. Augusto indicated that it was time to take action, and Sammy understood, ready to go back and execute the plan. Meanwhile, Susan had brought Zavala to the room where LJ was being held, but when Zavala opened the door, there was no one inside. Susan quickly kicked Zavala to the ground, grabbed a guard's gun, and killed them all. Her first act was to call Lincoln. Soon, a new warden took office, feeling that it would be better to release the prisoners. Michael and the others were returned to the prison, and Lechero breathed a sigh of relief, knowing that the plan could proceed smoothly. Unbeknownst to him, Sammy was brewing a grand plan. Michael returned and asked Lechero for a phone to contact Lincoln about LJ. Lincoln was furious, saying that LJ was fine, but Susan was angry. Michael told him to stay calm, assuring him that as long as Whistler was still there, everything would be fine. In reality, both Michael and Whistler understood that Zavala was no match for the company. Whistler revealed Susan's name, knowing that she would surely handle the situation. Michael went to find Whistler, making it clear that he would get him out, but he wanted Whistler to tell Susan that he would avenge Sarah. Sammy took out a gun from a box, and Lechero's position was soon to be threatened.
Please subscribe to my channel. Share different movies and videos every day.